Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and as you have been following it, you know that I have been doing videos about modeling, entrepreneur, art and nature. So today I want to share more about myself and what I'm actually doing here in Vietnam. So I am an artist, a silk painter. And today I welcome you in my home studio, and we are going to do a silk painting today together. And I will also tell more about my passion for silk painting. I learned silk painting actually from my mom, who's also artist and teacher, and she taught me about basic techniques, and directly I started to like this silk painting much more than some other art style like acrylic painting or drawing or even oil painting. So after learning this from my mom, I got pretty excited. I made a lot of scarves. I made also graduation work for children's art school in silk painting style. And after that, I actually went away from silk painting for a while because I decided to focus on more other areas. Then later I studied oil painting because I wanted to have more experience in artist area, and I studied oil painting in university, and after that I studied to become an art teacher. So after I graduated my master's, I was really stressed out from the graduation work writing, because if you have written the thesis, you know how much stress it can create. And I was searching the way to release myself from the stress and find some hobby to do. So I remember that I was really into silk painting, and I started to do silk painting again. So this is actually the time when I was starting Lazy Silk. In that time I didn't have this name ready. I just made many silk paintings, and I had an idea that I want to grow it to become a business. And I went to the market, I started to sell my silk paintings, and I got excited about this area and I like this technique. And then after I come to Vietnam, I have carry on developing my silk painting brand. Now beside silk scarves, we also provide workshops for people if they want to paint their own scarves, or we can provide fabric for Vietnamese traditional online dress, or also teach people how to paint their own fabric for Vietnamese dress. Because I think silk painting has so big and rich culture behind. I really want to preserve handmade art techniques, because everything what I have experienced and learned have been about handmade. Silk painting is really important part of culture from east to the west. I just excited to carry on and spread this message. So right here you can see that I have already prepared the silk on the frame, and I used a needle and a wire to attach the silk and stretch it out using these wires. Why do I stretch it out? It's because I want to start the drawing on it, and it needs to be up from the surface that I can draw with the lines and colors. If it would be on the surface, it would sink, everything sink together, the color, the drawing and the silk, and it will not come out. So we paint with the brushes. We have a special silk painting colors, Dynaflow by Jack Quart from USA, and we have also the lines. This is a Uta line, good for creating a barrier for the colors. So if we draw something with that one over, then we can separate the colors from each other. So that is very good for drawing. Why do we need to separate colors? It's because silk yarns are very smooth, and this color is acting like a watercolor. So if you know that you paint watercolor, then the colors blend together into each other. For silk, this is same. It acts the same way. So this water-based color, silk color, I paint together with water and it mix with another color. They will run into each other. Then we have also salt. We are going to use some salt from here to create also patterns on silk. While the color is still wet, we can add salt and it will observe the color melt and create white little lovely dots to have a pattern. Finish the drawing, the flowers. I use this pen. This is a transparent pen, so I draw with that one directly on silk. In the past, I use sketches under the silk, but I draw with a very dark color lines that I can see through silk, and then I directly draw with a line. But right now, I have found this Phantom pen. It's the name of it. And I found it in our shop, and actually it's really easy to use. I just draw, and then after some time the drawing will disappear from the silk. So right now when I finish drawing, I need to put the line and start to already apply it on the silk. Otherwise, if I wait until tomorrow, then the drawing will be lost. Drawing the image, and I have used a different color of gutta lines. This is the first time I mix transparent gutta together with the color to create the colorful lines. So I'm really excited to see how this experiment is going. And like you can see, I use like orange and green is blue, and some black for the inside of the flowers. And right now I'm leaving it to dry that I can start to paint. So that's all for today. I will take a rest now and let it dry naturally. I can also dry it with hair dryer, but if I'm not so hurry, I leave it just leave it on the table and it will be dry.